Hello fish lovers, welcome to the new episode of Fish Terminology. In today's video, we'll be learning about 5 fish terminology beginning with the letter E. So let's get started. The first term is elasmobranch. You might have heard this word if you learn about shark, rays and their allies. Elasmobranch is the subclass to the cartilaginous species belong to the shark, rays, skates and swordfish species. What separates them from other fishes? One of the key features for elasmobranch is their lightweight, flexible and strong skeleton made of cartilage instead of bone like other fish. Other characteristics including the replaceable row of teeth and the appearance of gill slits on each side of their body. Believe it or not, elasmobranch have evolved since 400 million years ago, making them one of the skillful predators that possess many high-developed senses. The second term is effluent, which is associated with aquaculture waste. It refers to the wastewater discharged from aquaculture facility, either from the hatchery or processing facility. Generally, all aquaculture practice by using any type of system will release nutrient load effluent outside from the farm to the environment. So, this effluent need to be treated prior to the releasing to avoid any harmful contaminants that could lead to environmental disruption. Several effects have been reported when untreated effluent from aquaculture farm were released to the environment. This include disease widespread to the wild fish, eutrophication due to nitrogen wastage from feed, and even the spread of transgenic or exotic species to the wild that would destroy the ecosystem. The third term is evisceration. This word emerged from the word evic, the visceral, or in other words, removal of the visceral organs from the animal. So if somebody asks you to eviscerate the fish, it means please remove the fish guts or all the internal organ from the fish, then you're done. The fourth term is estuary, which is the coastal ecological system where the river spread out and slow when it meets the sea. This condition will produce gradient salinity between saltwater and freshwater, which range from 0.5 to 35 parts per thousand. This area is where we can find many coastal fish species including mudskippers, archer fish, snappers and even salmon and eels. On the other hand, estuarine is the word refers to the form in the estuary or belong to the estuary. For example, estuarine birds, estuarine currents and so on. The last terminology is urohilin, meaning the ability of the organism to tolerate wide range of salinity. Urohilin organism can be divided into two types. Firstly, those who could adapt in different salinity changes regularly, where most of the species live in the estuaries, such as mollies, striped bass and killfish, and another group with a life cycle that require them to migrate between the sea and freshwater, such as salmon and eels. Well, that's all 5 terminology beginning with the letter E that you should know. If you like this video, please consider to subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to thumbs up and share this video. Until then, thank you for watching and see you next time.